screaming. I will be singing and dancing.
Yes, yes, it's all on that.
My Jesus, my Jesus, your beloved is singing. I will be singing and shouting and chanting for the rest of eternity. My daddy, my daddy, your baby is singing. Daniel, come on stage. I will be singing and shouting.
Kadosh, 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 kadosh. It's a moment, a moment, a moment of you and the King alone. It's an audience of one. If you like, you can sit, you can lie down, you can kneel, you can lift your hands. It's your moment with your Father. Nakwabudu. Na kuabudu wewe ni chanzo cha uhai wangu. Na kuabudu, na kuabudu wewe ni chanzo cha uhai wangu. Na kuabudu, na kuabudu wewe ni chanzo cha uhai wangu. Na kuabudu, na kuabudu wewe ni chanzo cha uhai wangu. Na kuabudu, na kuabudu Yesu. I want us to close our eyes. Please reduce my sound. Reduce it. Just reduce it so we don't make a lot of noise here. I want us to close our eyes and focus on the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. We came to draw strength. We came to draw power. We came to draw virtue. Listen, there's something that is happening in this atmosphere, the atmosphere of Kenya at large. And that revival that you're talking about is heavily dependent on men and women of the secret place. Those who are worshippers. Those who will be found travailing in the secret place. Those who will be found travailing in the secret place. This thing that we are talking about, this revival that we are talking about, it is right here. Right here. Shaka kakosopa. It is here in this room. It is here in this room. It is here in this room. Open up your hearts. Open up your hearts. Hi. Shana makatada bradaba rama sopa rakatoya shana baka sipaya shara namas seratapa sapaya shara basapa. That revival is here.
God, sing for him all is he. Osopena da 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 da. Rico sopaka da da da. Osopi. Isikuri. Yechedi. Isiri.
Holy Ghost,
that will never run dry.
that will never run dry. You're the well, you're the well that I drink from. Yeah. Jesus, fill us again, Jesus, fill us again, fill us again, fill us again, fill us again, fill us again. Fill us again. Hayakata bragada banada basa. Rakatakata brababosipa. Shokopaka Rami Supa Supaya.
God is here. Ha. His spirit is heavy in this place. Pour out your heart to him. Aya onoko sima. Pour out your heart to him. He's here that he may fill your cup. He's here that he may fill your cup. He wants to fill you again. He wants to fill you again. We have come to draw from you, Jesus. Eranana soliba. We have come to draw from you, Jesus. Ayayaya bossima. Maureen has come to draw from you, my King. Hey, yeah, 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 yeah.
Lord, your Lord, your Lord. Upon the cross, we raise a song. We raise a song. For you are God and God alone. Hallelujah. With our hands lifted. Unto the Lamb, unto the Lamb upon the throne, we raise a sound, we raise a sound. Oh, for you are God and God alone. Shout of praise in this place. You can do better than that. Do better than that. Apostle, I honor you. I truly love you. My heart loves you. I love you from now till eternity. Arama soliba. Can we give our asharama soliba? I want to read a scripture here, and then we will do a song. A pastor friend of mine says, in the presence of God, we say CCK. Yani chochote chaweza kutokea. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. So he normally says and encourages people to sit well. Yani kaa vizuri. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. I have entered meetings and I have seen, you know, the way people go back and they have huge testimonies, humongous testimonies, and you wonder where you are, but you are in the same room. It will not be said of anyone in this place. God is here and he's already given everyone what they desire. In the name of Jesus. My desire, my heart's prayer has been that in this season, this revival we are talking about, that Maureen will not be bypassed. And that is your prayer as well. That is your prayer as well. Whatever it is that needs to be done, whatever God needs to align in your life for him to use you, may he find it. May you be ready. May you be aligned in the name of Jesus. This scripture says, so it says, thank you, Apostle. It says, and every creature which is in heaven and on earth and under the earth and such as are in the sea and all that are in them are
God saying, blessing and honor and glory and power be to him who sits on the throne and to the Lamb forever and ever. Then the four living creatures said, Amen. And the 24 elders fell down and worshipped him who lives forever. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. That's what we came to do. That's what we came to do, both in word and in song. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So even before I hand over this microphone, I'll sing one song and give back the microphone, Apostle. Is it okay? I don't know what time, how much time I have. I wasn't given the program. Some of us can sing till next tomorrow. There's a song that says, Ebenezer, Ebenezer. Are you singing like you are at the market? Look, good. Now use your angelic voice, your heavenly voice, okay? Ebenezer, even Apostle knows it more than you. Ebenezer, 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 your dance. Is that your best? Is that your best? Yeah. People tell me that my relatives are in Nigeria. I should locate them. You say, everybody testifies you are good. You are good, Jehovah. Hey! Okay. Now we will raise the key a bit, but we'll sing, you know. So raise it for me. And then just give us a tempo mzuri ya kucheza. apostle. And then you see those people know how to move.
Everybody testifies you are good. You are good, Jehovah, you are good. Everybody testifies you are good. You are good, Jehovah, you are good. Everybody testifies.
Everybody, you should be having a smile. Hi, everybody.
Jehovah, you are so good. You are so good. Jehovah, you are so good.
You are so good.
Jesus, you are so good.
You are so good.
Yes, you are so good.
You are so good.
Jesus, you are so good.
You are so good.
Papa, you are so good.
You are so good.
Shout to the Lord.
Woo!
Give a shout to the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Jehovah, you are so good. That you are so good. We thank you and we bless you. Thank you for being so good to us, Lord. Thank you for being so wonderful to us, Lord. Thank you for being so loving to us, Jehovah. Thank you for being so good to us, Lord. We lift up your holy name. We thank you and we bless you. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. Shout to the Lord. Heads and hoods and you come in a sweat, Kweli. Anyway, we bless the name of the Lord. Welcome. Say hi to 2-3 people and tell them welcome. Welcome. Karibuni sana. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. How many of us are blessed? And I bless the Lord for this day. It has been long awaited, but finally it came. So tunashukuru Mungu sana. Sasa kama haukutoka nyumbani kama umeambia God, umeenda nasikianga inaitongo siju kulambano. Wangapi wamelambano? How many of you have contested and contended? Aya, hakuna? Mumekuja tu mwone the pretty apostle and then you go home. Is that it? Ama you've come to receive something. Now, we are going to read from the book of 2 Corinthians. We are preparing ourselves for forgiving. Amen? We are preparing ourselves for giving. There's no house of God that will go empty-handed. Every service has to have an offering. We'll also reap sparingly. And he who sows bountifully will also reap bountifully. So ushers, please, as I'm reading this verse, kindly, for those who need envelopes, give them, or of necessity, but for God loves a cheerful giver. And God is able to make all grace abound toward you, that you, always having all sufficiency in all things, may have abundance in every good work. Bless the name of the Lord. So, we are about to give. And we are going to give it with a heart full of praise. As I'm just about to bring Minister Maureen again to give. And then you come as Minister Maureen is giving us another Nigerian song. I don't know if you're coming to South Africa. Or you're coming back to Kenya. You dance with a heart full of praise. And you give God your offering and say, this is it I've brought before you. Ushaenda kwa kanisa watu wamekunja tu uso wamepeleka offering. Na amekuja amekelea hapo hivyo na anarudi kukaa chini kama amepigwa ndio atoe offering.
Great and mighty God, you are able, Jesus, you are able. Great and mighty God, you are able, Jesus, you are able. Put your hands together. Put your hands together.
Jesus!
You are able.
Yes,
you are able.
Yes,
you are able.
Yes,
you are able.
You are able.
You are able.
You are able.
Jesus. Exalt you. We bless your holy name. Let us pray for our offering. Father, we thank you and we bless you. Thank you for this time in your presence, Lord. We give you glory and we exalt you. Thank you because of the offering that is before you. Father, we lift it up before you. And as I take this offering, Lord, the desires of their hearts to offer the offering, we pray that you meet their needs according to your word, oh Jesus, that you fulfill their needs, Lord. We pray and we bless this offering. May it be acceptable before you. We thank you and we glorify your holy name. In Jesus' name we have prayed.
Amen.
Amen. Yeah, can we clap for the Lord one more time?
Woo!
Can we clap for the Lord one more time? Aya, even celebrating you, God.
Woo!
Let's celebrate the name of Jesus.
Yes!
Hallelujah.
Yes!
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you. Praise and worship, you may have your seat. Thank you so much for the beautiful ministration. Amen. Amen. Now, we are about to enter into the eating of the word. we are now coming to the real course. Amen. Prepare your hearts to receive from God. So without much ado, let us celebrate the woman of God, the apostle in the house, the vessel that God has prepared for us this day. Let us celebrate God because of this grace. Apostle, we love you. We love you, apostle. Welcome you. Karibu sana. Karibu sana. Karibu sana.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Bwana asifiwe. Bwana asifiwe. Praise be the Lord. Amen. This kind God, oh, I have never seen your type, oh. This kind God, oh, blessed be your holy name. This kind God, oh, this kind God, oh, I have never seen your type, this kind God, oh, blessed be your holy name. This kind, this kind, this kind, this kind God, I have never seen your type, this kind God, blessed be your holy name. This kind, this kind, this kind,
this kind God,
I have never
seen your type.
This kind God,
this kind God,
blessed
be your holy name.
This kind God,
this kind God,
I have never seen your type.
We are prophesying.
Ooh.
We are in a prophetic atmosphere. My God. God has wrecked me. God has wrecked me. I don't know about you, but I have received what I came for. I didn't come to minister. I came to draw from him. You know, the Bible says that those that wait upon the Lord, those that wait, wait. Sometimes it's not about the asking. It's not about the, he already knows our needs and desires. He knows that, the Bible says, the Lord is my shepherd. My shepherd. I shall not want. Hey. Hey. Let me tell you. You know, we all have needs. You got needs. I got needs. I got them. But sometimes, the needs have to stay aside.
Receive this living sacrifice. I am your worship.
I am your one. la musica tala mase kayanda asopia takaila mazatina makadoya akalia da kasupaya na sopena elika sopalia tolina mazeta ashita yalika la mazatela ashopala ekashopetele masatia etala makasopaya akatulia mazetina atela kasopa ashapela ekia tolia masatia atena makabuske taladia agazo pida etia la masko padia asheta la basapaya asheta ya la paya asheka tele paya ataita paya asoka itala mai sheka sopaya ashipada ashala basopa apaka apakaya apakaya ashole ashipata yaza atela akabia sopela asupata ya asola.
Hallelujah. Holy Spirit, right now, we welcome you into this atmosphere. We declare this is your place, Holy Spirit. We declare, Lord, that it's only your presence that we desire this afternoon. We thank you, Holy Spirit. We thank you for the healings. We thank you for the chains that are breaking.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
We thank you, Lord, for the renewal in strength.
Thank you.
We thank you, Lord, for the new level that you have assured
thank
us.
Thank you, thank you.
We thank you, Lord, for your opening our eyes.
Thank you. Jesus.
Opening our ears. Thank you, my Father, because life will be transformed.
Yes, Lord.
Men will be made alive again in the Spirit.
Amen.
Men will be made alive again in the Spirit.
Yes, Lord.
Your sons and your daughters shall be made alive in the Spirit.
Amen.
I decree and declare, Lord, that by the life-giving Spirit, my Father, my God, come and visit us today.
Amen.
Come and visit us today.
Amen.
Come and recharge us, Lord.
Amen.
Come and set us on fire.
Amen.
Come and set us on fire.
Amen.
We ask you, Holy Spirit, that you grant us access into the realms unseen, into the realms invisible.
Amen.
And Father, my God, that you will reveal to us the glory, the majesty, and the splendor of the King of Kings.
Yes, Lord.
We pray and worship all these things in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Open the book of Exodus, chapter 16. Exodus. You are a blessing in Jesus' name. Exodus 16. Somebody, the Lord tells me to tell you. The thing that has fought your life for a very long time is about to break under this anointing. Some of you came here with yokes. Uzito, you know, umegandamizwa na shetani. You came here heavy. The Spirit of God is about to break it from you. You are going to leave this place very light. Very light. Very refreshed. I want you to pay attention to the word. Your deliverance and your healing will come through the unction of the word. Woman of God, Prophetess Esh, please come to sit in the front. Things that have been pending in your life for months, I come here under the unction of the Spirit, and I declare there are some pending things that are about to become manifest in your life. There are some pending things. You know, the enemy can make you be kept pending. When you are supposed to go in, it's still pending. You are making that phone call, it's still pending. But it's about to change. It's about to change. I see the Lord releasing crowns upon people. I see the Lord releasing crowns. When you have a crown on your head, if you're crownless, there is nothing good that can come to you. But when there's a crown on your head, there is also favor. There is also distinction. There is distinction coming to somebody. Distinction. You know what distinction is? Where the Lord makes you distinct. When something is distinct, it stands out. It's different from the others. There are people the Lord today is choosing. He's setting them aside for greater works, greater exploits. You came here, if you came in a crowd, you'll have to choose today. Because it will be a solo affair.
What God is about to do with you in this season will take a lot of discipline. Say discipline. Are we in Exodus chapter 16? I want us to open Exodus 16. Somebody will have to be very quick in helping me with the verses if the screen is not working. 16. Exodus 16. God is about to deposit a fresh grace. Somewhere there in the corner, there is a grace that is going to be poured out. A very strong grace. And you will cease to be the woman or man you have been. I'm telling you. God is about to make you experience greater grace. Greater grace. Exodus 16. Are we there? Exodus 16. I'm going to be talking to us about hunger. 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 This is the word that the Lord gave me. And I'm praying that it transforms us. We're going to read together. Exodus 16 from verse 2. Verse 2, I'll read all the way until verse 5. Hallelujah. No, actually, until verse 7. The Bible says, and the children, no, then the whole congregation of the children of Israel complained against Moses and Aaron in the wilderness. And the children of Israel say to them, oh, that we had died by the hand of the Lord in the land of Egypt. Oh, that we would have died, that we should have died. We should have died. In Egypt, Moses, why did you lead us out of Egypt? Listen, you will understand something. When we sat by the pots of meat. So they are remembering Egypt. What they can remember is the pots of meat. The pots of meat. And when we ate bread to the full. Hello? These are people God has delivered from heavy bondage. These are people God has brought out with his mighty hand into a place where he is taking them to a new level. Say a new level. God heard their cry. The Bible says that when God called Moses to go to Egypt, it is because the cry of the Israelites had reached his throne. And when you cry, God doesn't ignore you. He sends help. The thing that we need to realize is that God always hears the voice of the righteous. No matter the situation, God hears. Let's continue. When we ate pots of, when we sat by the pots of meat, and when we ate bread to the full, for you have brought us into the wilderness to kill the whole assembly with hunger. Ha. Then the Lord said to Moses, behold, I will rain bread from heaven for you. And the people shall go out and gather a certain quarter every day that I may test them, whether they will walk in my law or not. And it shall be on the sixth day that they shall prepare what they bring in, and it shall be twice as much as they gather daily. Then Moses and Aaron say to all the children of Israel, at the evening you shall know that the Lord has brought you out of the land of Egypt. And in the morning, you shall see the glory of the Lord, for he hears your complaints against the Lord. Somebody say hunger. Hunger. We are supposed to have hunger. Some people here are fasting. I know they are hungry. When you are fasting, you get hunger. But there is another type of hunger that we all get from time to time. It's not just hunger for food. It's hunger for the things of life. So you look this side, you see your friend is driving a nice car, you hunger for it. You see somebody has just gotten a promotion, you hunger for that. You see somebody has just gotten married, you hunger. So we have been built with a nature that hungers for things, hungers for food. What is hunger? Hunger, it is to be devoid of something. When you are hungry, you are devoid of something. You are devoid of, naturally speaking, when we speak of hunger, we speak of devoid of food. Your stomach is empty. It's crying, it's grumbling, like some stomachs here. It wants food. But sometimes, our hunger can lead us to things that are not of God. Hunger. Hunger is good, and hunger is dangerous. Because hunger can make you. You see, the Bible says, yeah? The Bible says that those people, prostitutes. What drives prostitutes? It's hunger. Proverbs 16:26. What drives them? It's hunger. It's not because they want to sell their bodies. They want to pay their bills. Hunger. What drives you? Hunger can be a driver. It can drive you. It can take you to places. What makes a robber steal? Hunger. What makes a con man? Hunger. What makes you cheat? Hunger. What makes you change the receipts in the office? Hunger. That's the dangerous side of hunger. It can lead you into sin. The hunger of these people that you're seeing here, the children of God in Israel, was leading them to sin. And the greatest sin they performed was not even adultery. The greatest sin they were performing here was grumbling, not against Moses and Aaron, but against the Lord. Do you understand what I'm saying? I want you to follow me because this is going to lead us somewhere. We need to hunger for the Holy Ghost. We need to have a hunger that is different from the natural hunger. Hunger is very good. It's very spiritual, by the way. And that's why when God wants to take a man to a new level, God will demand that you become hungry. There is no new level without hunger. The desire for a new level starts with your hunger. If you're speaking to the Lord in your heart and you're telling the Lord, Lord, I want a new job, that is hunger that is speaking. I want a new dimension in the spirit. Hunger. So for you to go to the next level, you need hunger. Somebody say, I need hunger. But not, it's not hunger for biscuits. It's not hunger like this one that we see here where they were missing the pots of meat and the bread. You know what the Bible says? The Bible says that man shall not do what? Shall not live by bread alone, but by every that proceeds from the mouth of the Lord. And so God has a desire that we train ourselves to be hungry, both physically and spiritually. Do you understand what I'm saying? The Greek word for hunger is painao. And it means to suffer want. Painao. To suffer want. To suffer want. To be needy. It is to have an ardent craving, a very deep, intense craving. That's how the Greek describes it, to have a deep, intense craving. So for that word to be used, it doesn't refer to food only. It refers to many other things, including the spiritual aspect of hunger. Now listen to me, guys. Have you ever been in a place where you are fasting and you really want to eat? You are fasting. You have committed yourself to fast. You are hungry. You really want to eat. But you know that if I eat, I'll have spoiled everything I'm doing. Because inside of you, the Spirit of the Lord will give you an alarm that you are about to destroy the level that God is taking you into. Because you see, spiritual hunger, unlike physical hunger, physical hunger needs a physical, it gives you physical satisfaction. It satisfies your belly. Spiritual hunger is not the same. Spiritual hunger will not satisfy your belly. Spiritual hunger will actually require your belly to be empty so that you can be spiritually satisfied. So you cannot be both physically, you cannot be eating food, having a full belly, and still calling on the name of the Lord, and waiting on him, even Jesus fasted. There is a reason God is calling us to be disciplined in this season. There is a reason God is saying, I want you to start desiring something you haven't desired before. When you want to know that you are not in a good place spiritually, you lose desire. You lose desire for God. You lose desire for prayer. You lose desire for fellowship. You lose desire. Your desire disappears. And you get desire for other things. You can be very busy with other things, but not busy for God at all. It's because your spiritual hunger has been lost. Now, I want to show you something about Exodus 16 as connected to the New Testament and why Exodus 16 is a reflection of the church in the present day. Do you remember when Apostle Paul said, "Oh, you foolish Galatians, who has bewitched you? What you started in the spirit, now you are doing in the flesh." I look at us now and I see people who are not ready for that visitation with God. Why? Because we treat God like he is a supermarket. We only come to God when we have needs. So we don't care about that relationship, that koinonia, that communion with God. So we ignore the place of fellowship and we go into the place where we make God a supermarket. And every time you open your mouth is God give me this, God give me that. Remember, we are in a generation where everything looks flashy. So everybody wants flashy things. You want a flashy car. You want a flashy shoe. You want to be as flashy as the celebrities you're seeing online. But I want you to remember this. If you don't have hunger, you are not a landing strip for the Holy Spirit. The only place that the Holy Spirit can land, the only place, the only fertile ground. You know, the Bible says, a broken and contrite heart, I cannot despise. Who is a broken person? When you are broken and you are crying to the Lord. It is the hunger for the Lord. It is the hunger to be in his presence. It is the hunger for God to take notice of you. I would rather go into prayer and cry, "Lord, have mercy on me," than tell the Lord, "Give me something." Because I've realized everything that I need, he supplies. Our hunger needs to be aligned to God. Do you know the Bible verse that says he will give you all your heart's desires? What is a desire? What is your desire? Your heart's desire, let me tell you, your heart is the residence of God. Your heart is not your emotions. Let us forget about the soul. Your heart is where God resides. See, if your heart is full of other things, the only desire that you will be communicating in the spirit is the desire that this Israelite had, meat and bread. We want meat. We want meat. Don't give us anything. We don't want favor. We don't want Give us meat and bread. Are you a meat and bread person? This teaching is supposed to make us rise up to a new level this afternoon. It's going to be very short, but it's going to drive somebody to the place where God wants you to be. The meat and bread people, I'm sorry, today God is going to challenge you. Because these guys, they didn't see the goodness of God. They didn't. Do you remember when they decided they will even build a golden calf? These guys could never wait on the Lord. Isaiah 40:31 says, those who wait on the Lord shall do what? Shall. These ones did not have the capacity to wait. I want to show you something about these people. In Exodus 16, they did not have the capacity to wait. They were like small children throwing tantrums for a lollipop in the supermarket. You know your kids and how they behave. So they couldn't give Moses a break. Moses was a leader under a lot of pressure. You know, the Bible says God calls and then qualifies. Moses didn't feel worthy of the calling. But God entrusted him to lead the church in that time. Lead them, Moses. I want you to lead them so that we can cross over from the law and go to grace. That was his assignment. Let them leave the Sinai. You remember when God told them, you are walking around this mountain for too long. You have been around this Mount Horeb. This Mount Horeb, I talked about it in our teaching. I said, Sinai represents what? Sinai represents a thorn. And also, Sinai is related to Mount Horeb. So they had been in that place. And so God wanted them to journey away from this place, from the place of the law, from the place where you like to be told, don't do and do, to the place where you have a relationship with me. And by the fact that you have a relationship with me, you know what to do. Because the Bible says those who dwell where? In the secret place. They abide where? Under his shadow. Just come for a minute. For a moment. I'll show you something. If you are under a shadow, actually I think there's like a small shadow there. If you are under a shadow, so assuming Minister Maureen is under my shadow. She's under my shadow. I want you to see. So this is God, and this is Minister Maureen. So Maureen dwells in the secret place by the things that she does. She's a worshiper. She loves the presence of God. I didn't hear Maureen singing some songs za kuitisha Mungu vitu. Tupatie, tupatie, tupatie. Tupatie yo mkate na nyama. So by the virtue of her being here, everything that God is, Maureen becomes automatically. Because the Bible says in the book of Genesis that we are created in the image of God. And so when we connect that to what is happening in Psalm 91, we see that if we dwell in the shadow, then we are beginning to receive the fullness of the image of God. Because remember, when Adam fell, something happened to us. It's like we were veiled. But I'm showing you something. Now, when Christ dies, what happens? The veil is cut off. And so God wants that those that dwell in him, they radiate his glory. You see, Jesus is inside of you. You don't live outside of Jesus. It's not like Jesus is there. Sorry, sister, you're in high heels, I forgot. And then when you need Jesus, you call him in. No, it doesn't happen that way. Let me have your daughter Prudence, because she's a bit younger and she's not in high heels. Just stand there, woman of God. I want you to see something. So, this is this young girl, okay? So when she needs Jesus, she does not pull Jesus into her situation. Jesus is already in her situation. Do you understand what I'm saying? Jesus is, she's not. If I am Jesus, and she calls herself the daughter of Jesus, she doesn't have to keep on pulling me every time. No, she doesn't. What she needs to do is to remember that I'm with it. So she needs to stir me up so that I am revealed and I am manifested. Are you catching me? And so these Israelites in Exodus 16, they did not know that God, you remember the Lord told them, I go ahead of you. I go before you with a pillar of cloud and with a fire. I will guard you. That was a revelation of the fact that they were carrying the presence of God with them. And that they did not need to grumble or complain against Moses. Because complaining against Moses, you remember Moses was told, my friends, Moses was told, when he was going to Egypt, that you are going as a god. Please open the Bible, find it for me. And Aaron is going as a prophet. So God was in their midst. They forgot that God was with them because they saw a stammerer. And so, they did not see El Shaddai. They did not see Yahweh. They did not see Jireh. They didn't. Not at any one point. So when they were demanding for the meat, God was listening through his ears. And they say, these people are foolish. I am in them. I am all around them. I have encompassed them. Yet they are still complaining for small thing which is within them. Do you know the Bible says that when they journeyed in that desert, in that wilderness, 40 years, that their shoes never got destroyed. Okay, so let me tell you something. What hunger is this that they are talking about? If you're wise, you're following me. They were not hungry. They were grumblers. Their anxiety, their fears, their, you know the way you can be anxious about your rent? You can sit down, my dear sister and a little girl. Do you know the way you get anxious about your rent? The way you get anxious about a debt that you have? The way you get anxious about the job offer? The job offer. You understand? You're anxious. It's not that it is not coming, but you have become anxious because of your emotions. This is how they were. It is not that God was not going to provide. Bible says, who is man that you're so mindful of him? So God was mindful of these people, but they were not hungry for God. Follow me. Walk with me. Their hunger was on the perishables. Am I speaking to somebody? Their hunger was on the Bible says, the Bible says in Colossians 3:2, focus not on what? Earthly things, but on the things that are set above. The things that are eternal. The things that cannot be bought with money. But you are focusing on the pot of meat. Egypt represents the place where God delivered you from. Egypt represents your former glorious, the fake glory, of course. Glorious life where you are working in an office and being paid a salary. Hadassah, you don't have a salary now. Lord, give me bread and give me meat. You don't have a salary. How are you going to do that meeting? Is it my meeting? It is for the Lord, by the Lord, and it is his bill. Listen, the Bible says in the book of Exodus 16, then the Lord said to Moses, behold, I will rain bread from heaven, and the people shall go out and gather a certain quota. To do what? To test them. So you can cry to God because of your current circumstance, because it is pressurizing you. Yes, you've got 300,000 to pay off. You've got school fees. You've got whatnot. Everything is overwhelming. But the Lord can decide, let me provide. And see whether your mind will change. Whether you will swing to this other side. Whereby you already know me as Jireh. The Israelites, what they lacked was a revelation. They did not have a revelation of who God was. Remember when Moses was being sent. Come on, Holy Spirit, thank you so much. When Moses was being sent, Moses said, Lord, whom shall I tell? Sent me. And God said, tell them, I am who I am. I am who? They don't need any more explanation. If they don't catch that line, Moses, I'm sorry. Many of them will have to fall. I'm preaching good. Many of them will have to fall by the wayside And when you go into the New Testament and read the book of Hebrews, you discover that many fail. Many did not make it because their hunger was not for God. Imagine God, my dear sister, Sheila, delivering you from heavy bondage. The bondage of your ancestors. The bondage of your father's house and your mother's house. Remember, Abraham was delivered from the bondage of his father's house. He was delivered from all the sorcery and the divination of his father's house. The Israelites, they were delivered from Pharaoh's bondage. They were delivered from marine spirits because Pharaoh worshipped the spirits of the water. They were delivered from heavy work. Slavery. Yani zile vitu zote shetani amekuwekea. Imagine your deliverance. You have been delivered, my dear sister. But then you can't see it. Your foresight is on the perishables. So every time that you hear there is a meeting, you come and you have a list before God. Lord, I want this. Tick, it came. Lord, I want this. It came. Lord, it must be first class next time. I'm not entering economy. I'm your servant. I can't. Last time I was in economy, they pressured me. No sitting there. Am I preaching to somebody there? Lord, if you don't give me a new car, some of us, God gave us a new car and immediately we wanted to sell it. I'm like, Lord, this one, what do I do with it? You ask my sister here, she's laughing at me. What do I do with this one? It's too big. What do I do with it? You panic. You're like, Lord, am I supposed to be driving this thing? You have a scarcity mentality. A scarcity mentality is very bad, by the way. Never tell your children things like when they come and ask you, Mommy, can you buy me a toy? I don't have money. Never do that. You'll destroy them. That one we can talk about when they talk about children. You'll destroy them. Tell them, I am still saving the money to buy it. When they grow up, they will not grow up as people who hide money in their pockets. They don't have money. You know, money is scarce. You need to hold on. You need to the little money. Don't do that. Now listen. Let's go back to the teaching. The Lord already knows that Prudence requires school fees for her daughter. But God is calling you into the inner chambers, but you're still in the outer court with Estella. You're in the outer court. You're not in the Holy of Holies. My brother, you're listening to me. You're not there. You are in the outer chamber. You come before God like we came today. Everybody is worshiping the Lord. Everybody looks like they are worshiping the Lord. But you are not, because your minds are on what will I get from God today. So do you know something? You never enter the Holy of Holies. Maureen may enter the Holy of Holies by herself. And the rest of us, we are hanging outside because we are still worried about the things that we need, which we think God does not know about. God knows what you need. Full stop. I am not speaking out of arrogance. I am not speaking because God has given me plenty and a bad, but God has shown me, Hadassah, I am a promise keeper. I can supply to the dot. In Kesha last night with my children until 4 a.m. The night before, I did not sleep. The night before, we were up by 3. I go to bed at 2. And then I wake, because I am I'm a late sleeper. I'm not good with the morning. I'm not a morning person. I thank God even my last job was not a job that involved me waking up. You know, you can sleep, and the Brits, when they're waking up in London, if I'm in Kenya, I'll wake up, I'll be 2 hours, is it behind? Behind, right? In the cellar. Is it behind, right? Ahead. Yeah, you need to, you know, I'm asking a question. You're just looking at me with your pretty eyes. Looking very good in green. Now listen. And God knows I hate mornings. I do. But guess what? The Lord now decides, let me show you, because I preached and told you. when we were entering the month of May, that it will require us to do what? To go into Luke 5, and we go to verse 5, 6 there, to launch into the deep. That's what we declared in May on our online platform. To launch where? Into the deep. Come out of the outer court. Come out of the? Come out of the begging God. Begging, begging, begging. We can't train our children to pray like that. Unfortunately, it's not right. That's not prayer. Our children will become entitled Christians. And we have got a bunch of entitled, mature, in the body, believers. Kindergarten. Because we are entitled. To the extent that you actually get angry with God and refuse to go to church. God has taken too long. That was Exodus 16. Are you seeing them? These guys, they had barely been in that place for too long. They hadn't even started experiencing trouble. It was not because there was a hornet. Imagine complaining, not because God has not supplied. It's because you are just reminiscing last month God gave you 50K instead of the normal, you know, he gave you 50K more. Now this month, where? So you live in a constant state of panic. If you live in panic, you can never worship God. The Bible says, if I did not give you a spirit of, but there is no way you can worship God from a spirit of fear. That's why the opposite of the fear is sound mind. So instead of being caught up in, he hasn't given, you should be in the place of thanking him because you know he will. This is what is called ascending in the realms of the spirit. You can only ascend if you have learned how to wait. Now, waiting is a sign of hunger. Are you with me? Waiting. Waiting is hunger. Waiting. Because you cannot wait for something. I told you the Greek word phenial says it is as in worship him with vigor. Yeah. You begin, you know, the Bible says love your God with all your and all your and all your. Love your God with what? Love your God with all your and so and there are four things and strength. Now, with all your strength, intensity. So when you are loving on God, there has to be an expression of some divine energy in the place of waiting. So waiting is not for complacent people. Waiting involves you going before God, kicking your shoes, taking the right posture, and worship God intensely. Anxiety. And then the Lord says, be anxious for what? Nothing! Because you can't change a thing. You can't do a thing. You can't. You can't even command a blessing to yourself. But in all things, in prayer and supplications. So you are supposed to be waiting without grumbling, without distraction, so that you don't stay in the outer court and think that Jesus is the one you keep on running to when the rent is finished. Rent imeisha. And then you go back, rent has been paid. Then you stay again in the outer court for some days doing your businesses. You come back. Hey, Nini, Jesus, boyfriend slapped me. He's leaving me. Hiya. Again, you go back to your things. You leave Jesus where he was because he is the same yesterday, today, and forever. He's unshakable. He's unchangeable. He sits on his throne. He is glorious. You leave him at his throne. As you go to chase for things, and when things are not working, you still come back. Jesus, I wanted to tell you, by the way, I've been Now you're getting exhausted. I want you to see something. You're getting tired because you keep on running. You keep on running. You're doing marathons with Jesus. You keep on going. Now you'll hear another thing somewhere. You go again to that direction. Come on, give me those quiet strings, gifted hands. You go to that quiet direction. Now, there is situation. What's happening in town? You go there. You are not going there because you are hungry. You are going because you are looking for something to satisfy your hunger. And the real hunger that you are supposed to have is not there. You are not even sure whether you hunger more for Jesus anytime. There is no sign in you. Kataina makasina la ukotu na mazatai. Azopa katulia na sapedilia. He says it is time for us to go back to the first love. It is time to go back to the first love. The hunger you have had for the past years that has not taken you anywhere. Can you imagine? Can somebody read Proverbs 6:30? Proverbs 6:30. I hope I'm going to be able to take us into this journey. You know, hunger is an aching within you. The hunger for God is not like this one for other things. The hunger for God is like an ache. My God, for the previous few months since I came into Kenya, I have been so desperately hungry for God. So desperately, yani, God has, I don't know what he went to do with me in America, but he took me through some experiences there that made me realize, you know what, it doesn't matter. Some of you here are praying to go to America. Somebody asked me, Hadassah, why did you come back? I mean, you got your children with you, so why did you come back? Our priorities are different. Yeah, our desires are different. Do you understand? There are people who hawange rudi. Kudu? Kudu? Miniko states. Narudi kudu? Ata, even my sister here told me, Apostle, stay. Yeah, stay. In fact, invite us. We need to come and... But you see, it's not a bad thing at all to desire such. But the Lord, you alone are my soul's desire, and I long to worship you. I long to you, Lord. Hey, somebody open for me Song of Solomon's. Aye, katalama zekete. Somebody open Song of Solomon's. Maureen, stand behind me or take a microphone where you are. Ashienda bokusketia na kalia bosataya. What hunger do you have, my dear sister? You want a nice hair. So I go into the shop in US. I buy the nice hair. I wear it. It doesn't look that good. Maybe a different color. I go back again tomorrow. Take Uber. It takes me there. I land. Oh, you're back again? Yeah. I'm still looking for some hair, you know. That one doesn't look no good. I pick the hair. I wear it. I look good again. Because my hunger, it can, as a physical hunger, is insatiable. I want you to understand that. I used to believe that if I enter United States, Dubai, London, I've traveled to many countries, I must come out with at least 10 handbags. I must come out with at least 10 shoes. I must come out with different outfits. I must buy the most expensive hair. I must enter fossil shop. All my watches are fossil. They're not so expensive. They're gentle. But they're good for me. And this time I went to the US. I came back with no fossil. Got only one watch left. Only one watch. God has been dealing. God has been dealing. You know, I really wanted an iPhone. Then came the iPhone. Now I couldn't even use it. Rubbish. Put it aside. Went back to my Android. Jesus must help us.
You alone are my heart's desire, and alone to worship.
Read for me Proverbs 6:30. Read it if you found it. And somebody open Numbers 11, 4 to verse 6.
It says, men do not despise a thief if he still satisfies his soul when he is hungry.
Do not despise a thief. When he steals to do what? Give me the strings. Stay there. when he steals to satisfy his belly. So let me tell you something. Everything we do because of desire, some of it is very unholy. You can become a thief, but you are a believer. You know what? Because you are robbing God the time. You are robbing God what? The time. So that you can satisfy what? Your belly. Are you seeing a new revelation with that Bible verse? We keep on using it for thieves and say if a thief is caught, he has to return sevenfold. But I'm telling you, God might be looking at you and saying, you have been robbing me time. I desire to use you. I desire to take you to a new level. But you can't surrender. Strings, please. You can't surrender. You're too busy running. You're too busy chasing. You're too busy looking. Do you know what the Bible says? I think in the book of Jeremiah, it says, and you will seek me and find me. If you seek me with all you are. Say it after me. We haven't been seeking God. We haven't been seeking God yet, guys. Because the kind of seekers we have in the day, the kind of seekers we have today, are those who want needs to be satisfied. The other day I was having a conversation with my Winnie Stella, and I was telling Winnie Stella, listen. She's a minister at the Spirit Hub. I told her, listen, by the way, celebrate her. This girl came all the way from Amsterdam. What one at Aftanga Mungu? By the way, just to connect with what I'm saying, she when we were in one of our mental health workshops, she mentioned, I just desire to come to Kenya to just for a fellowship. That's what she said. You know, you miss these things. Shall perform it. You shall come. Wasn't that my reply? We didn't have to rabashanda. I said, the Lord shall perform it. She's here. If you ask me how she landed here, only God knows. But if your desire is aligned with His desire, listen, when we use that Bible verse in Psalms and we say, and God shall satisfy all the desires of my heart, open for me that Bible verse. Satisfy that desire only if it aligns with His will. Open for me the Bible verse that says that when you ask, you shall receive if it is in His will. Open it. You cannot give God your fleshly desires all the time and expect to be a friend of God. You cannot. You cannot give Him time according to your carnality. That's why I've decided this time around, Lord, I'm not going to joke. I'm not going to joke. If it means we will live in the 3 a.m. hour looking for you, we shall stay there, Lord, till we see your face. Till we hold you for your glory. I will do to behold you as my King for your glory. I will do anything. I will do anything. Songs of Solomon chapter 5 verse 10, where we say, my beloved is white and ruddy, chief among 10,000. His head is like the finest gold. His locks are, until you come to a love affair not with your boyfriend. Song of Solomon is a love affair. It's there for a reason, because we are not just in a relationship, we we are in a love affair. Jesus is the groom. We are the bride. The groom has to romance with the bride. The bride has to romance with the groom. That's why the Bible says, husbands, love your wife as Christ loves the church. That's why the relationship between man and woman and the Christ and church is the same. The intercourse between man and woman is the same. Koinonia between the church of Jesus and Jesus himself. We have got very few romantic Christians. We have got opportunistic Christians. I don't think you love an opportunistic girlfriend. Who loves opportunists here? You hate it when your friends are opportunists. Christ is calling us to a love affair. Listen, this is him. This is him. This is chief among 10,000. Who is that? It's Jesus. My friend, he's not talking about anybody else. This is Song of Solomon. We never read it, Song of Solomon. And as I was preparing for this meeting, the Lord kept on telling me, go read Song of Solomon. Read it. Read Song of Solomon. That's what I am looking for. I am looking for a romance. Katana masaka tolobosaya. Katayala maseke telebozaya. To get into his presence, but you can't. You're trying this route, it's not working. You're trying even with give me an envelope. Come on, somebody, give me an envelope. You know, you are here. Come, I'll use you. So this is your envelope, and you know, you come, take somebody, sweetheart, take a Bible, take your Bible there. Yes, I am Maureen. Come with your worship. So Maureen is gonna come with her worship. Okay, she's trying to get into the presence with her worship. This one is trying to get into the presence. And you know, she has been away. She has been away. So now when she comes, she's going to go only to the book of Psalms. And she'll begin to quote, I rebuke you, devil. Contend for me, who contends with me. That's what, you'll go to Psalm 35. Use that warfare. And this one is going to try and use her seed. And now, woman of God, I want to use you. Sit down. Are you visible? No. Come, bring a chair for her here. Very quickly. Quickly. Sit down. And the woman of God looks really good. Now listen, she's God. She's sitting in the place of God. And so, they are all dry. They have not been communing with God. You know, it's like you have this boyfriend. You don't talk to him, Jose. You don't talk. The girl doesn't talk to you only when she's looking for something. Oh my God. And now you come back again. Not because you were hungry. Remember what James 4 says. That you ask but you do not receive. Because you ask with the wrong motive. To satisfy the lust of your flesh. They cannot even come close to God because you know what? They are in the mountain. So try to get in, to give God there. Yeah. You are. dominating in that area. The worshiper, the true worshiper, has dominion in that area, in the spirit realm. The rest are standing in the outer court with all their beggings, with all their problems, with all their needs. God is not moved by our need. God is moved by our fellowship, by His word. Now go down even and cry from that outer court. Cry there in your outer court. God is not moved by your tears. Cry, weep, wail. But you are wailing from the outer court. You don't have access because you denied it to yourself. And the only way back will not be a seed. It's not the way back. It's not the seed. No, it's not going to do it. Even if you slap it with 100,000, it will fall to the ground and it will accomplish nothing. I'm preaching good. You are about not to return to the next meeting. You are not coming back, right? This is not what you like. I am leading taking us back to where we should be. To worship you. Say it again. You from a place where you feel some pain, from a place where you are walking and you can see eye bags, because you have sacrificed. I pray for you, woman of God, that you will not hang in the comfort zone. You will not stay in the comfort zone. That you are coming up higher. 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 In the name of Jesus, you are not going to stay in the comfort zone. I didn't finish even reading Songs of Solomon for you. It says, my beloved is white and ruddy, chief among 10,000. His head is like the finest gold. This is Jesus. Alright, his locks are wavy and black as a raven. His eyes are like doves. The gentleness of the Lord. You know, doves are very gentle. So Jesus is gentle. And by the rivers of waters washed with milk and fitly set, his cheeks are like a bed of spices, banks of scented herbs. His lips are lilies dripping liquid myrrh. The beauty of the Lord cannot compare to the beauty of our idols. You are beautiful beyond description. He's beautiful beyond understanding. You see, the reason we are very, very opportunistic is because we don't have an encounter with him. We really don't have a revelation of him as a father or as a friend. We were just invited in, but we have not yet sat at the table. But when you open the book of Revelation, when you open the book of Revelations, it says in 8:20 that Jesus is knocking at your door. He's knocking at your and inviting you to a table to dine with him. Yani, Psalms 23 says he shall prepare a table for you. But guess what? After, if he prepared the table, where is he? After he prepared the table, let me ask you. So the Lord will prepare a table for you, and then God will not be at the table? Hello? So if he has prepared a table, you have gone through your shadows of death. You have gone through the valleys of uncertainty. You have gone through all the battles and the warfare. And then he says, but my rod and my staff, they comfort you. Okay? And then after that he says, thou preparest a table for you in the presence of your enemies. First enemy that we are dealing with here is the adversary, Satan. Not just your, these haters. No, those ones, God is still blessing them. My God, time is out. I'm not done. But time is out. Listen, my friends. If he has prepared the table, he is at the table and wants to eat with you. Can you open Revelation 8:20, my dear sister? 3:20. Read it, sir, if you have it already. Listen, I just want to wrap up. I know I will continue with these teachings. I can't exhaust it. But I want to tell you something. Every time he comes to someone new, he says, hey guys, we need to pray. All you guys are coming on Spirit Hub online, and all you're doing is praying for your needs. When I say let's intercede for the current generation, an intercessor is a friend of God. I want you to remember that. So when you're called into intercession, please go. Do you know what you're doing? You're developing an intimate relationship with God. And you are first on his list because you are a friend. He can reveal secrets. He can tell you there is a child that is about to die. Wake up. There is a child that is about to be diagnosed with cancer. Cancel it before the devil takes in the report. You are sleeping. Oh. Intercessors. So me, gimme, Jimmy is not people of relationship. Those are not secret place people. The me kind of people, they are not secret place people. Secret place people have a revelation that no matter their... Apostle Paul said, we served God in hunger, in thirst, in shackles, in prison. They served God. It doesn't matter what you are going through. My brother, God is able. You have to believe in the ability of God. I want to say something. The bread that the Israelites wanted was that bread, Yakubula. But in the New Testament, the bread is Jesus. So then they were, you know, God saw that their desires were upside down. They still desired physical bread. he was like, when will these people ever learn? And you know, these guys were provoking the anger of God, the wrath of God, because they didn't see God as their father. They didn't see God as their helper. They didn't see him as Jireh. Don't store it. Kesho bado itakuwa. It will still be there tomorrow. And those who dared take some and put, it got spoiled. God was dealing with his people. And he wanted them to realize there is another bread you are looking for. Give me water from the well that never runs dry. Jesus is the water. In a dry, weary land where there is no water, my soul is thirsting for you. He is the water, he is the well, he is the bread, he is the only thing that can satisfy. I don't know what your desire is today, but I perceive in my spirit there is a great spiritual hunger in people here. There are people who are tired of gimmicks. They are tired of games. They are tired of running around. They just want God. Sign, the first sign, you are dissatisfied with your current level. You don't want it. You hear people are praying at 3 a.m., I am there. You are dissatisfied. Signs of spiritual hunger. When you see that, one more. Maureen looks at herself and she sees the way I've been worshipping is a joke. This is not even acceptable. I'm going to stay in the closet more. I'm going to pray some more. I'm going to indulge, not in voice practice. I saw people that are closet people. Closet people. Closet people. I tell her all the time that when I come close to her, the sound of worship becomes so alive in me. And any time somebody will visit me, we will start to worship. We will forget what we came to do. It will be serious. We will not discuss it. And then say, what have to come to discuss? Badai. You have to be an atmosphere shifter. But atmosphere shifters are people that spend time in the presence of God, not begging God for bread and for meat. They want the real bread. Bread of heaven. Me till I want no more. Bread of heaven, fill me. There are some parts of your life that the Lord will fill with himself. Totally. Totally. You will become so selfless. So selfless, Mary. Dorothy, you are about to rise up to a greater level. Let me tell you, greater level needs greater sacrifice. Greater level needs greater commitment. You want a bigger job. Are you ready to sacrifice? Oh, you want to go to London? What are you ready to lose? There is a price to pay. My friend, I didn't know I would be able to function today. I realize that indeed, sleep is for the grave. And then I started looking at my clock. Say clock. My clock as a person. And I said, Lord, this year, I'm going to be 44. Time is not waiting for me. There are things I still need to achieve. What am I going to present before you? When I come before you, Lord, what will be my report? What will be my report? What will I say I did? What will I say? Which souls have I harvested, Lord? Which ones, Lord? What am I even doing? Am I even serious? You think I'm going to go before the Lord and tell him, I won 50 souls. 50. When you are supposed to have won 5 million, you won 50. Hadassah, and you are standing before me as a small, cute daughter. Lord, you know, aki, ingi tu ningumu aki. bye-bye. Bye. I wave you bye-bye. Because there is a bigger mandate. There is a larger call. There is a higher call. It requires discipline. It requires sacrifice. It requires commitment. It requires consistency. Hatana kamaze telebazaya. I mean, you have turned back like Lot's wife so many times. You said, I have decided to follow Jesus. You're just following Jesus. We're checking M-Pesa. M-Pesa. Hey. Hey. Apostle, I don't think I can come for that service. I'm too down. I'm broke. I've decided to follow Jesus. My boyfriend just walked and he's not talking to me. I've decided to follow Jesus. Look at Dietrich and Nana. Now who will take care of them? They are alone in the house. They were in Akesha last night. It's not even funny. But I cried before God in the Kesha yesterday. I was carrying both of them. One on this side, one on this side. They were both very sleepy at about 4. And I was telling God, Sasa, Nifanye Aji. And then I just started singing. My helper,
but before we get there, I want us to go before
cry out and say, Lord, I want you to satisfy me with yourself. I want you to satisfy, to break. Hallelujah. Sayendele makandeda ya. Ye la karabo sanana mokadela eda. Ele la mapo ila de tubia nasa yete. Upada kaya letana le polo zatetela. Shape itaya la kopo sote.
The ground, whatever you want.
Niwe, niwe tu.
Hajaya moyo wa. Just like a new way, new way, new way.
Jesus, the Son of God.
Power in the name of Jesus. Take it. Take it in the name of Jesus. Take it. Power. Power in the name of Jesus. Power, Mary. Power in the name of Jesus. Kata, 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 kata. Asapaya. Yes, yes, yes. Power. Yes. A new level. A new level. Kashopa, kata. Kashopa, kata. Paka, pakata, kata. Power in the name of Jesus. Come on, come on, come on. Come on. Oh, Kaya Laba Baba Beatrice, it's time for a new level. It's time for a new level. It's time for a new level, Beatrice. Ashopa, Ashopala, Asokata, Asokata, a new level, a new level, a new level, a new level, in the name of Jesus. Ashakalabasa, Ashakalaba, Ashakataya, power, a new level. You have tried too long. You have tried too long. It's a new level, new level. Katala, katalabo, katalabo, ashatalabo. Power in the name of Jesus. The power of God for a new level. The power of God. The power of God. The power of God. Shatayalaba. Akapapataya. Okayataya. Asakataya. Aseketeketekete. Akapapapapapapapapa. Ashatayalaba. Power. You are not staying on this level. I command whatever is holding you to break. Let it break. Whatever is holding you, it's breaking. It's breaking. Power in the name of Jesus. Yes. Yes, receive it. Break. Let her go now into new levels. New levels. New levels. Yes, receive it. It is time. It is time. The Lord says you are going to operate in a new dimension. In the name of Jesus. Jesus, hallelujah. Every yoke is broken from you today. The Lord says, I've set you apart. I'm going to use you. Now is the time. Let her go. Let her go. In the name of Jesus. Come on right now. Ascend, 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 ascend. The Lord says a pending breakthrough, a pending breakthrough. The Lord is giving it to you right now. Receive it right now. I say power in the mighty name of Jesus. Power in the name of Jesus. Receive it. Receive it right now. Receive it right now. The Lord says, for I have called you on my holy mountain to stand in the gap. Now take your tools. Come to the mountain. Come come to the mountain. Come to the mountain. Come to the mountain. Yes, there. 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 Yes. 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 The Lord says, I've removed the destruction. Now I want you to come in. I am drawing you in with my love. For I know what you have been through. But this is the time. I am going to show you who I am to you, daughter. Now is the time, says the Lord. Take the power of the Holy Ghost now. Ashetele kalabasoka. Ashapala kato. Healing in the name of Jesus. Some people in this room, there is a healing grace as it is coming upon this woman. It is coming upon some people. There is a healing grace that is coming upon you. Let me tell you, the Lord says, listen, there are things that you have struggled for before. You're not going to struggle again. And because of this word, because of your obedience to this word, listen, daughter of Zion, whatever the enemy made you to, hey, my God, there are people I see God is giving you tools. You need tools, and there are tools. In the mighty name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, yes. The healing is coming upon somebody. The healing is coming upon somebody. Shata kalaba baba. Shata baba zaya. Father, thank you right now, power. Kalaba baba baba zaya. Kalaba baba 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 shata. That you are about to be invited to a place you never thought you could step in. It's the higher dimension. Just get ready for it. A place you never are, Makasho Toleba. New levels. New levels. Sorry, just be,
not afraid. I'm not afraid.
Healing rain is falling down.
He's fighting for you.
Healing rain.
He's fighting for you. He's fighting for you.
Not afraid.
He's fighting for you. He's fighting. He's fighting. He's fighting. Oh, Katala Banzaya. He's fighting. Yes. Yes.
Yes.
This mountain too long. You have been on this mountain too long. Banta. Oh, Kusoko Tolobo. Zataya la baba. Ashetaya. Akala baba Banzaya. Now. 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 Higher. It's your time. It's your time. It's your time, says the Lord. It's your time. Yes, the power of the Holy Ghost. E shakat mayalaba. I shake a tayalaba. Akato kobosa. Eketayalaba. Azeketaya. Akabashe. Akalabashaya. Ah, yes. Power. It's your time, says the Lord. It's your time, says the Lord. Out of the belly, I shall tell
of
a second.
Out of my belly shall flow rivers.
Prophetic grace. Prophetic grace. Prophetic grace. Where is Winistella? Makasho Kotoleba. Winistella, prophetic grace. Where is Dorothy?
My belly shall flow.
Azokopa, the prophetic, let it flow now. Oko Shatalaba, let it flow now. Let it flow. Yes, 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 yes.
The prophetic. Welcome. The prophetic grace. Yes.
Aya,
listen. There is another grace that is coming. There are people who are about to be taken into realms of glory, and you will begin to manifest the glory. As I touch this girl, I want you to believe you'll receive it. There. She is coming.
Jesus.
There. Yes. Take it now. Power. Receive it. Hold that so tight. Let her receive. Right now, I declare it. It is coming upon you. There is a grace. Fire. Be consumed with the fire. Yeah, the Father, the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Oh, my God. There are people here. All you need is to experience the love of the Father. The love of the Father. This is what He's giving you today. He's giving you a gift. Love. That is love. You are about to go into places where you will worship God because you know He loves you. Ashepakaza. Ah, Jesus, thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Come on. Let it come upon you. A revelation of His love. In the name of Jesus. Get me that girl. Oh my God. Say my name. Shatayama. Shakala mazikete. Atiale kalima zo pregatolia. Lord, fill this your son with a new grace. A grace He cannot explain, Lord. Ashidile makazo peteleba. Ashani makalaba soko laba zande. Lakatolobo zika yanta labosa. I see the Lord opening new things for you. I see the Lord opening new things for you. There are things you tried in the past, but the Lord says, forget the former. I am going to open up new things for you, son. I am calling you into a place of intimacy. And as you come closer, as you draw in closer, these things will open up for you. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. What has happened to the worship team? What is Dorothy? What I saw concerning your life must come to pass. What I saw concerning your life must come to pass.
Open the floor.
Hey, Lord. Father, right now, I declare, Mary, come here. I saw something about you. And when I saw it, I don't know if she's one of them that has despised herself, but there are several of you here. You have despised yourself. You don't think like God can do anything with you. You think He can do it with other people, not you. I'm telling you, God is about to surprise you. God is about to surprise you. There is a new level, my dear daughter, here. That new level is coming upon you. It's a level of the prophetic grace. People will start to call you prophetess. Don't run to it. Because you will prophesy. God will show you things. It's an impartation also on you, Mary. I saw that very well in a vision. And you said, me, I cannot. The Lord told me to impart. Where are my people? If you are around me, Sheila, come here. Impartation. Impartation. Winnie Stella, come here quickly. I'm doing it very fast. Bear with me. Shopakaya. Yes. The glory. Yes. There you go.
Ay, acá, tío. Rock, 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 rock.
Lord, release the fire on me. Tell the Lord, release the fire. Yes, yes, yes. Yes, yes, yes. Yes. In the name of Jesus. The woman of God there, the one who is crying, this one, the Lord is fighting some heavy battles. And then as the Lord is fighting those battles, listen, listen. The Lord is giving her mantle. Her mantle. The one that was stolen, there goes power. Then when I touch this one, the Lord said, I am going to beautify. I am going to beautify. I declare, the Lord is beautifying your life. The Lord is beautifying your life. The Lord is removing the old garments. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, the Lord is lifting you now. The Lord is lifting you now. Move behind. Move behind. If I've talked to you, move. Power. Power. Yes. 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 I declare right now, you're going into your new level. A new level of grace. A new level of power. You are coming out. You are coming out of every oppression, of every stagnation. The Lord breaks you out today. Ha! Shakapaya. Table, and that table, the Lord sits on it, and when he sits on it, he anoints you with fresh oil.
You anoint my head with oil, my cup runs over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me. You anoint my head with oil, my cup runs over.
Yes, Lord.
Surely goodness and mercy,
yes. Take it.
Shall follow.
Take it. Take it. Take it. Yes.
Head. You anoint my head with oil. My cup runs over.
Yes, Lord.
Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me. Oh, you anoint my head with oil. My cup runs over.
Yes, Lord.
Surely goodness and mercy
I break every yoke. I break every yoke. I break every yoke. And I release power on you. I release power on you. I release power. A new level of grace. A new level of your anointing. Upon the children in this room, the power of the Holy Ghost that breaks every yoke, that breaks every chain. In the name of Jesus, the power of the Holy Ghost. Yes, right now, power of the Holy Ghost, power of the Holy Ghost, power, power. Yes, yes, yes. In the name of Jesus,
you anoint, you anoint my head with oil, my cup runs over.
Power of God is available here for the children. I am declaring upon them. The Lord shall use you. The power of the Holy Ghost is upon you right now. Let him go, Catherine. The power of the Holy Ghost. The power of the Holy Ghost. Let him go. Let him go. Let the boy go. Let the boy go. Let the Holy Ghost fill him. Yes. Yes. In the name of Jesus.
My head with oil, my holy goodness and mercy shall follow.
You are not. You are not. Let the children come to me. I declare for the power of the children. Power for the children. They are preserved. They are preserved. You will use them, Lord. I declare, Father, you will use them in the name of Jesus. Power of the Holy Ghost. Every chain is breaking.
My God runs over.
Hallelujah.
Surely goodness and mercy follow me.
Father, right now I release power. I declare the powers that have oppressed you are breaking today. There is a new power coming upon you. You serve God. You are a priest in the house of God. God will use you. I declare every power that has fought you today is breaking in the name of Jesus. It's breaking. Every yoke of the enemy is breaking in the mighty name of Jesus. I release grace. 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 In the mighty name of Jesus. Whatever has fought your life, whatever has oppressed you, today I judge it. I judge it. I release judgment on any power right now. Give me tissue for this young man. I'm releasing grace upon you. You have entered a new level in your life as a young man, and I'm declaring there is no power. God has put a heavy mark on you, a heavy mark, but the enemy is also contending. But I announce today, by the mandate of heaven, the mandate of the Holy Spirit, you shall serve God. You are preserved. You will be used of God. You will go higher. Your children carry great stars. They carry great stars. But they are a target. And today I hide them. I hide them under the blood. And I declare they will bring you great joy. In your season, in your due season, you shall celebrate because of your children. You shall not cry because of your children. You shall celebrate because of your children. I announce today, whatever fought them before, whatever fought them before, every foul spirit, today I command it to go. Jesus. Freedom in the name of Jesus. Whatever was oppressing you, today I judge it. I judge it. I declare you are set free. And whom the Son sets free is free indeed.
Every hiding must come down.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You'll not struggle. Okay. But you will do things with the help of God. Amen. Amen. Receive it in the mighty name of Jesus. Receive it in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. I am announcing to every witch. I am announcing to every wizard that is oppressing your life, that is oppressing your family. They are defeated. They are defeated. Their mission is aborted. Their mission is aborted. Their mission is aborted. I command right now satanic dreams to cease. Any person here getting satanic dreams, I command them to cease. Cease. Toka kabisa. Toka kabisa. Bring me that lady. Bring her. Bring her. Toka kabisa. In the name of Jesus.
I jump all over the enemies.
Glory be to God.
The name of the Lord
Jesus.
Hey. There's somebody here.
Hallelujah.
You are supposed to go through certain doors.
Glory.
There are certain doors that you are supposed to go through, but the enemy is closing the doors while you are at the verge of entering. If you're the one, I'm praying for you right now. Who is that person? Oh, you are too many. I can't do this again. Just stretch your hands. I decree and declare any adversary standing at your doors is scattered in the name of Jesus. Your doors are open in the name of Jesus. Your doors are open in the name of Jesus. Your doors are open in the name of Jesus.
I see the doors are opening.
Glory be to God.
Father, right now.
Jesus.
Father, right now, I ask you.
Glory,
I ask you right now, Lord. In the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Even the children are receiving their portions. There is no exception. In the name of Jesus, let the power flow. Let the power flow. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. If you're sick in the body, before you leave, I want to pray for you. If you're sick in the body, do we have anybody that is sick in the body? I want you to touch where you are ailing. I want you to touch where you are ailing. Power. Power. Healing in the name of Jesus.
You sent your word to heal my disease. You are the Lord.
I release grace.
How great is our God.
Shatababo. Somebody told favor.
Darkness tries to hide.
A whole army with a jawbone. Supernatural ability. You are about to scatter your enemies. In the secret place as you worship God, you are about to scatter some powers. You are about to scatter some powers. The things that have harassed your family, today we subject them to the blood of Jesus. As we declare your victory, as we declare your ascension to the higher levels. In the name of Jesus. Hey, young man with the red jacket. You need to get ready for how God is going to use you. You understand what I'm saying? It's just this koinonia that God needs from you. Your destiny is very much sorted with the Lord. It's sorted. Now it's you to show the Lord, I'm ready. I'm ready for what you're about to do. Get ready. Don't forget my words. You'll come back with the same words. Get ready. That's it. Get ready. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. As we are closing, I want to pray for people who need God's provision. Yes. 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 Take it. Power of the Holy Ghost. Power of the Holy Ghost. Yes. Yes. Manifest it. Yes. There it goes. That's how he does it. Hallelujah. Father, I thank you for this one. There is a great glory on your life, sister. Glory. Where you are glory. Mlete.
My protector.
Are you in ministry? Are you connected to ministry anyway? You used to sing. There's a great glory on you. There is a great glory on you. Mary, touch the girl here. As I release grace on you right now, I declare. Enter and receive songs from heaven. Those are the great realms that Jehovah is calling you into. I declare the anointing upon Maureen, Minister Maureen, is a secret place anointing. Let it come over you. Who is a singer here? Receive it. Receive. Yes, there it comes. There it comes. Come on. Yes. Yes, bring her to me. Bring her to me. Ashekala Mazaya. Ashekele Mazaya.
Rivers of living water. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It's happening. Hallelujah. Kolobobo shataya.
Out of my belly shall flow rivers. Rivers of living water. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Out of
flow.
My belly.
Flow.
Flow, rivers, rivers of living waters.
In the name of Jesus. Jesus. The grace. Receive grace. Receive grace. Yes, receive it. Receive it. Grace for new levels. Grace for the secret place. Receive it in the name of Jesus. Fresh oil on you. Fresh oil on you. Father, right now I thank you for the little boy. I declare grace upon him, a grace of preservation, a grace to serve you in his time, a grace of purity upon him, a grace of wisdom upon him. In the mighty name of Jesus, let him dream dreams and see visions. In the name of Jesus, grace in the name of Jesus. Grace in the name of Jesus. Okay. We are doing our communion and then we leave. You have to excuse us. This is what I heard the Lord say. This is what I heard the Lord say. It is a season of being helped by the Lord. Somebody say, I will be helped.
I'll be helped.
I am helped.
I am helped.
It is a season of being helped. You're not saying it as if you mean it. Nataka, the smart lady at that back place.
Sopate akataya labaka sopa asheka paya.
The Lord is helping you. 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 Receive it. Receive it. Ashekataya akala baba baba shanda ala katoloro bobo. Shakatala bosaya, shakatala bosaya, ekataya la bosaya. The Lord is helping you. The Lord is helping you. Asheka pa pa pa, akatoko lopo zikataya. The Lord is helping you. Father, right now, help from Zion. Help from Zion. Your struggles are God's struggles from today. Your situation is God's situation. Now go and be hungry. Be hungry. I want you to say, I reject.
I reject
my past level.
My past level.
I enter. My new level.
My new level.
I enter. My new level.
My new level.
Hunger also leads to encounter. Hunger leads to encounter. In the book of Acts, when Peter was very, very hungry and he was waiting for his food to be prepared, the Bible says, is it Acts 10 or is it Acts? It's Acts 10. Thank you. Oh, you know your Bible. That's very good. Peter was sitting and waiting for his food to be prepared. And the Bible says he was hungry. Then the heavens opened. And he saw a vision. And in the vision he saw animals. And God said, eat. And he said, they are unclean. And the Lord told him, don't call what I call clean, unclean. But what was this vision about? It was a vision of a higher level. God was giving him a new assignment. Go from here. Go from here. Into the house of Cornelius. I announce to you, you are entering a new level. Entering a place of encounter. Between now and our next meeting, people will have encounters. The angelic, let her go, there. Don't worry about the beauty of the room. God allows us to be like this. Come on, my sister, hold my hand. Minister Maureen, my desire for this woman, and may it come to pass, is for her to enter nations and for her gift to be rewarded. Her gift to be rewarded. You know I love you, my dear. You know that I love you. My prayer today in this place, may you be demanded for more. Not by Kenya. A prophet is not honored in their hometown. She's a prophetic vessel. May you be honored by nations. May they call for you from other countries. May somebody see you. Receive it. Receive it. It is flowing from here. May somebody see you. May somebody take note of you. There, I told you it's coming. It went there. It went there. Yes, yes, yes. Power. Yes. May somebody take note of you. May the man of your life take note of you. May the spouse of your life take note. May your helper take note of you. Helper. Helper. Say helper is coming. My helper. Now, God is our helper, but God uses men to help us. Now, when you're saying my helper is coming, I want you to say it as you believe. God will send people to you that will help you. You are the first person I'm releasing it on. May you be helped. Unisala, come. Neil, give me the oil. Cover her new dress. Hey. Kasha pala kotolia mazaka batola. Azeka tolobozika. I know that the Lord is calling some people into international jobs. Who's ready for an international job? As I hold her hand, God is going to pick you himself, not me. The power will come on you where you are. For international job. International job. International job. As I release it on her, as I hold her and connect with the grace, I declare the Holy Spirit is handpicking you. International openings. There it comes. Bring the ones that are falling. There it comes. There are many katalabo saya. International doors, bring them. Yes, yes, power. I command it to open. In the name of Jesus, may your doors open. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. International. International. In the mighty name of Jesus, receive it. Receive it. Oh, green versus green. Receive it. Receive it. For your new assignment. Oh, the power of God is so strong here. Excuse me. Concentrate. There is something the Holy Ghost is marvelously helped. Marvelously helped. Capacity increase. And I announce after this, there is greater waiting. I am moving you from a level you have been for too long. In terms of your financial impact. And I'm placing you on a level you have never been before. A level you have desired but never been before. They will reconsider. They will reconsider. I put the mark of favor on you. I seal it with the blood. I seal it with the blood. I declare any power that is waiting for you on the other side to fight you, they will be disappointed. Their desire shall come to nothing. Oh, there is a power. There is a cover her, cover her, cover her, go ahead. Shakala mama maza. Cover her properly. Kneel, my brother. Oh, I just want to release our grace. Favor. Favor. You will not enter your new position with struggle and strife. Enter your new position with ease. Ease and favor. Ease and favor. I put it on you right now. You will remember this meeting. There it comes. Ease and favor. Ease and favor. Power. Ease and favor. Ease and favor for your new position. I release it on you. Ease and favor. 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 As the oil comes on your head. You know the Bible says, and I will exalt your horn like that of a unicorn. May your horn remain exalted. May your horn remain exalted in your new position. May your horn, as this oil touches you, I declare, your horn will remain exalted. Your horn will remain exalted. Open your hands. Wafungwe mikono. Wafungwe mikono. Jesus, imkutano inafaa kuicha sahi. Take this. Financial favor. Wapi wapi. Yapa. Financial favor. I put it on you. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Don't stand up. No, don't stand up. Don't stand. Don't stand. Don't come. Don't come. Receive it by faith. Receive it by faith. I'm only anointing them because Jesus. Receive it in the name of Jesus. May things begin to shift. May things begin to shift. May things begin to shift here. In the mighty name of Jesus. I announce a shift. I announce a shift. I announce a shift. I am every power that is still fighting you, contending with your destiny. I declare today we release a judgment on them. We release a judgment on them. We break the grip of the enemy. We break the grip of witchcraft. We release grace. Grace. Receive. Receive. Go forth and shine. Go forth and shine according to Matthew 5:16. Go forth and shine. Remove the other one. The other one. Go forth and shine. According to Matthew 5:16, go forth and shine. Go forth and shine. Please pour this oil on her, and as we pray for this girl, we call the sister into the kingdom in full. We annul the appointment with death. We annul the appointment with disfavor. We break the bondages that are running in the family. We break the bondages that are running in the blood. Claire, we call you out of nonsense. We call you out of perversion. We call you out of deception. We call you back into the kingdom. As I lay hands on her, may this power find you in your boarding school to deliver you. Father, right now. Father, right now.
Woven in abundance, moving in the spirit.
Goodness and mercy. May they follow you.
Goodness and mercy.
May they follow you.
May they follow you. Goodness.
And I pray for everybody here that grace is coming over us. Grace is coming over us. Grace we never had before. Grace we never knew we had is coming over us. And as it comes over us, Lord, I decree and declare, in this month of July, Lord, we are walking in abundance. We are moving in the spirit of the Holy Ghost. We are walking in favor. Doors are opening for us. Testimonies are chasing after us. Helpers are locating us. Keys are being handed to us. Offices are calling our names. Positions are opening for us in companies. Vacancies are arising for our sakes. I decree and declare that we have abundance of provision that we can even share. I decree and declare that as we leave this place, Lord, people will get strange phone calls. People will get emails. People will get phone calls. People will be appointed into offices. People will be remembered by people who have forgotten. Will speak for men. I declare we are all preserved. I declare we are all shielded. No harm, no disaster shall come near you. In the name of Jesus. And let us now declare the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ,
and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore.
Amen. Touch your neighbor and tell them,
surely goodness and mercy shall follow you all the days of your life, and you shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen.
You said